are faced tomorrow, any problem that you come with, when you are coming, you have this fear that this problem that you are going through, can you do it? Can he do it? There is nothing that is possible, impossible in his sight. It is he that makes impossibility to be possibility. He can do and undo. What a great God that we serve. What a great God that we serve. All other gods, they are the works of men. But he is the most high God. Because he lives, he can face you. Hallelujah, Jesus. He is worthy to be praised. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you.
I want you to have faith.
Amen. In the respect of the word of God, we shall be all on our feet. And I read Ecclesiastes chapter 10, the verse 10 of the chapter 10. Ecclesiastes chapter 10, the verse 10. Quickly I go. If the iron be blunt, and he do not wet the edge, then must he put to more strength. But wisdom is profitable to direct. Amen. 2 Kings chapter 6. 2 Kings chapter 6. I'll start from the verse 1. And the sons of the prophet said to Elisha, behold, now the place where we dwell with thee is too straight for us. Let us go, we pray thee, unto Jordan, and take thence every man a beam, and let us make us a place where we may dwell. And he can answer, and he answered, go, yea. And one said, be content, I pray thee, go with thy servants. And he answered, I will go. So we went with them, and when they came to Jordan, they cut down wood. But as one was felling a beam, the axe head fell into the water, and he cried and said, alas, master, for it was borrowed. The verses, and the man of God said where it fell, and he showed him the place, and he cut down the stick and cast it in thither, and the iron did swim. Everybody say, amen.
Amen.
Take your seats in heavenly places. I was reading a book. I am confused. I don't know if it's a Sunday school book. And somebody confirmed the story, and I want to tell you the story. It came to pass that there is a factory that cuts firewood. And there are people there, all they do is to go to the forest and cut wood. And as I was teaching this evening, or this afternoon, there was one mature person in the factory whose skill is to cut wood and knows how to cut it very well. And in the course of time, a young man was employed. And this young man was very stout, he had the muscles, he goes to gym every day, so he had got the strength. And he watched this old man and told him, good veteran, I would love to go into a contest with you. I know you've been doing this job for a very long time, and I've just been employed. But I know very well, I can do better than you do. So let's go into contest. The old man said, okay, I will go. Let's start. So the day has come for the contest. And when the bell has rung, this young man began to cut the trees one after the other. He was swinging from a tree to tree with all his muscles, with all his strength. He was swinging from a tree to tree and cutting them down from 8 o'clock to 5 o'clock all all he was doing was cutting the tree down. And the old man also was cutting his tree with a difference. This man was so old, but he was working there for long. He was affected by the Monty's law that you have to go to pension 66, 67 years. He's supposed to go on pension, but Monty's law have held him down. So even though he was old, he must work. It's not like a doctor who has gone to pension so young. Good. And when he cut a tree, he will sit down and be breathing in and out. When the young man was swinging from a tree to tree, this old man, after cutting every tree, he would sit down and breathe and take rest. After 5 o'clock, the supervisors came to count the trees that were cut. To the surprise of everybody, the old man has cut more trees than the young man. And it was frustrating for this young muscle man, the man was having more muscles. And he went to the old man and said, I have accepted the defeat. But tell me the secret. I was swinging from a tree to tree. But you, after every cutting of a tree, you sit down. But how come that you cut more trees than I do? And the old man said, young man, do you know one thing? Each time I sit down, I sharpen my cutlass. Hallelujah. Yeah. Hallelujah to somebody. Yeah. Each time the man sit down, he was not only resting, but he was sharpening the cutlass. The problem this evening I want to talk about is that some of us, we are working very well. We are cutting many trees, but we are doing with a blunt cutlass. Hallelujah. Fasting is a time that will take our time to sharpen the cutlass. Fasting is a moment of time that you will reflect and know where things have gone wrong, that you can be able to sharpen your cutlass. Fasting is the time that you can be able to understand your position before God. You can be able to work from here, either you bow or you don't bow, you are resting before the Lord, and all you are doing is to sharpen your cutlass. Whilst others are swinging from a tree to tree, they are not doing much. They were only using all their strength, but at the end result, they cut less tree. But because you take your time to fast and seek the face of the Lord, your anointing will be more than any other person's anointing. Yeah. Hallelujah. Last time I was preaching and I said, face to face with God, one of the things is to fast. And among other things which I did not mention, sharpening your cutlass, is that it gives you the ability to pray. It gives you the ability to reflect upon the Lord. And this even I'm saying, it gives you the ability to sharpen your cutlass. Hallelujah. So the young man lose the contest. Amen. Most of us, we have been working hard in the vineyard, but we are working hard and we don't see the results very well. We pray so much, but as I was teaching this afternoon, without faith. As I was teaching this afternoon, we pray without directing the prayer unto the Lord with all our trust in Him. But we pray so much, but we doubt if God can do it against the report of men. Hallelujah. And with this little doubt, we are using a cutlass that is not sharpened. We try to cut the wood, and we use too much time, but the tree is still there. Can somebody understand me this evening? Put your hands together for the Lord. Therefore, we have become spiritually blind. We pray so much, but we pray in vain. We sing very well, but we sing in vain because our cutlass is still blind. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We lift up our hands to praise God, but our hands are so heavy because the cutlass has made us so weak. If the cutlass is sharp, if you take your time to fast, if you take your time to rest in the Lord and sharpen the cutlass, one single prayer will move mountains.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You don't need to seek the man of God, but you'll be whole enough because your cutlass is well sharpened. You can be able to cut down the tree, remove the demon. Fasting is a time of reflection. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So get involved and dwell with you.
Amen.
If you're not involved this time, the next time, get involved. The old man waits and sharpens his cutlass. Wait on the Lord.
Amen.
It came to pass in the school of prophets, these people were called by God and they formed a school to work for the Lord. And they saw that the place where they were sitting or they were having the school was too small. So they asked if we can go and cut beam from the river Jordan. And Elisha said, why not? You go. Let's make the place big. The Bible said, I'm giving a short time. I have 10 minutes more. I'm going. The Bible said, as they were cutting the beam, one person lost the axe. The axe dropped in the river Jordan. Amen.
Amen.
What a disgrace. A man of God went and borrowed from the heathen to do the work of the Lord. And the axe lost in a muddy river Jordan. Hallelujah. We are doing the work very well, but somewhere in the line, we lost the axe head. Somebody there with me?
Yes.
We have the zeal to work, but somewhere in the line of our job, in the house of God, we lost the head of the axe. We lost the tool that the Lord has given unto us. The enemy wants to bring disgrace upon our life. What will you go and tell the person whom you have borrowed the axe from?
You will tell the person, I lost the axe. The person will say, oh, even children of God, you don't have even money to buy tools for their job.
And this man said, alas, I'm finished. Man of God, I'm finished. I don't know where you lost your property the Lord has given you. I don't know where you lost your passion for the job of the Lord. Our finance is gone in the river Jordan. The muddy river Jordan. And no one can go down there and pick it up. But this evening I want to say to you, if you can have face to face with God, no matter where your passion is lost, no matter where you have lost your property, God is able to cause it to swim and give it back unto you. Hallelujah. We only need to have it face to face with God and work with the people of God and know how it will work. I've told you before, River Jordan is a miraculous river. Joshua built a monument in River Jordan. Therefore, the river already has been dedicated unto the Lord. The other day, I don't know don't know where I was preaching, but I said, what is your monument? Joshua built a monument in Jordan River, and today the River Jordan is a place everybody wants to go and baptize. Otherwise, it's a place where Naaman had to go and wash down again his healing. Otherwise, it's a place where Jesus himself was baptized. And today, something's happening in River Jordan again. You, what monument are you building in the house of God? I don't want to come to that business. Today, many lost their business. Many lost their passion for the way. They lost the property, the wisdom, the knowledge God has given them is gone. Your ministry is gone because of problems. Even as we are going to face God tonight to pray, we are going to go before God in prayer with a special approach. With the approach that the man has approached the man of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's go back to that story. From the first five of chapter 6, 2 Kings. But as one was felling a beam, the axe head fell into the water. He cried, "Alas, master, for it was borrowed." And the man of God said, "Why fell it?" And he showed him the place. And he cut down the stake. He went to the man of God and said, "I have lost my passion. I have lost my business. I have lost my ministry. I have lost the zeal you gave me." He did not go to any other person, but he went to the man of God. In those days, the man of God represents God. So he went to God and said, "I have lost what you have given me." And the man of God did not say, "Well, how foolish you are. How silly you are." Shall we go to the book of Galatians chapter 6? Galatians 6. I was teaching on this a month ago. If you are there, read for me. Galatians chapter 6. The first one. He, the man of God, did not rebuke him because you are a lazy worker and you don't know how to do the job. But he said, "Take me to the place where the earth fell." I'm almost there. Don't waste time. I'm almost there. Galatians 6, nobody's there? Brother, hallelujah.
Brethren, if a man is overtaken in any trespass, you who are spiritual, restore such a man in a spirit of...
Amen! 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 If you have been overtaken because you lost your passion, thank you. Because you lost your finance, because you lost your anointing, you go to the man of God. That man of God should help you to restore you back. Hallelujah. Amen. Therefore, when this man lost, he did not go to, he went back to Elisha and said, "I have lost this. It was borrowed thing." And the man said, "Let's go back to the source. Go back to the first love. Go back to where God has called you from. Go back to where you received your anointing. Your anointing comes from God. So go back to God. Tonight, I want you to go back to God and claim whatever the enemy has stolen from you."
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the Bible said, the man of God cut a wood, placed it at the place where the iron fell. The wood represents Calvary. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The wood represents the cross of Jesus Christ. So tonight, I want you to proclaim the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the Bible said, immediately Calvary was preaching. Immediately the wood was cast on the place. The gravitational law of God has to change. The iron began to swim. How many people have seen iron swimming? What the doctors have told about you must change.
Yeah.
The natural calamity about my life must turn upside down.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. What the enemy must be given back unto you.
Restoration.
Hallelujah.
Yes, sir. With interest.
Go to God in prayer tonight. And the Lord is going to proclaim whatever is flowing from you. He's begin to swim upon River Jordan in your life.
Amen.
Get your fashion back. Get your ministry back.
Amen.
Get your anointing back.
Amen.
Get your fruit back.
Amen.
Get your gift back.
Amen.
Get things back that the enemy has stolen from you.
Amen.
It's going to swim on River Jordan.
Amen.
And you are going to claim it tonight in the name of Jesus. As you are fasting, you are really sharpening the cutlass. You are going to go to the field. You don't need much strength again to bring down the wood. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Tonight is going to be a great night.
Amen.
I want you to confide in God. Men will fail you. The very men, they are also looking for their way out.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Some of them have even lost their anointing.
Jesus.
Tonight is a time that we are going to see God at the face. And we are going to tell God where we lost our passion, our ministry, our anointing. Where we lost what the Lord has given unto us to use for his own glory. Where we lost it. Tonight we have to claim it back in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
No matter the situation in your life, God can turn things around.
Yes.
If iron can swim,
mm-hmm.
if water will come out of rock,
mm-hmm.
if river, Jordan River can dry down,
mm-hmm.
if the rest can open to you,
yeah.
God can turn things around in your life. Yeah. Hallelujah. And I proclaim to you that tonight is going to happen.
Yeah.
The man of God, he don't say, let's go home or something. He said, right now the iron must swim and it's wrong. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Tonight, claim everything back. Talk to God face to face.
Yes, sir.
Somebody may lay hands on you, but I want you personally who know what you lost. Talk to God.
Amen.
Amen.
Proclaim the blood. The new covenant blood. I'm preparing a message on Calvary. The place of new birth.
Yes.
Go back to Calvary. For the Lord has done it already.
Amen.
And you receive your blessing in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen. And God bless you.
Amen.